Hi, my name is Merani Muhammad. I am here to present you Zashman framework, which is developed by John Zashman. In 1987, John Zashman introduced a framework for information system architecture that has been widely adopted by systems analysts and database designers for the creation, design and production of complex machine systems such as airplanes. The framework as it applies to enterprise is simply a logical structure for classifying and organizing the descriptive representations of an enterprise that are significant to the management of enterprise as well as to the development of enterprise systems. It uses grid model based around six basic questions: who, what, how, where, when, and why. Ask of five nominated stakeholder groups: planner, owner, designer, builder, and subcontractors, to give a holistic view of enterprise which is being modeled. The rows represents the points of view of different players in the system development process, while columns represent different aspects of the process. The rows are separated as follows: scope, definition of enterprise's direction and business purpose, corresponds to an executive summary for a planner who wants an estimate of the size, cost, and functionality of the system. This is necessary to establish the context for any system development effort. Model of the business. This defines in business terms the nature of the business, including its structure, function, organization, and so forth. In other words, shows all the business entities and processes and how they interact. The third row, model of the information system. This is defines a business described in step two, but in more rigorous information terms, where row two describes business functions, for example, as perceived by the people performing them. Row three describes them specifically as transformation of data, where row two describes all the things of interest to the enterprise. Row three describes those things about which the organization wishes to collect and maintain information and begins to describe that information. Row four, technology model. This is describes how technology may be used to address the information process needs identified in the previous rows. Here, relational databases are chosen over network ones or vice versa. Kinds of languages are selected and program structures are defined. User interfaces are described and so forth. Row 5, detailed representation or builder's view. Here, a particular language is chosen and the program listings, database specifications, network, and so forth are all produced. In row 6, functioning system, finally, a system is implemented and made part of an organization. This framework enables senior business managers and IT professionals to understand the implication of key business and IT strategies that must be established for turbulent times. The Zashman framework is not architecture and was never proposed as such. It can be thought of as a multi-dimensional visual checklist. The artifacts that instantiate the cells of the framework for a given architecture are indeed architectures or subsets of an architecture. Depending on one's point of view, the framework itself does not impose architectural rigor. Although following its constructs would reduce the probability of mishaps in architecture defined using the framework. In fact, in later work, Zashman introduced some principles to guide the use of his framework and also speculated about some of the tools and methods that would make the framework's adoption less labor intensive. Thank you.